He is in the company of friends. President-elect Rodrigo Duterte admits many in his incoming cabinet are personally close to him. Nothing wrong with that, he says, and he appeals to the public to give them a chance to prove their mettle.
Kayo taga Maynila, do not be too judgmental about the person. Kung sino ang mga kakilala ko, di mga classmates ko, mga kasama ko sa dormitoryo, yung mga brad ko.
These include the incoming executive secretary, secretary to the cabinet, his spokesman, and chosen heads for the departments of finance, transportation, justice, foreign affairs, and the peace process. Others hail from Visayas or Mindanao, or worked with Duterte when he was mayor of Davao City. There are those who served under previous administrations. From the academe, the left, as well as other industries in the private sector. Political analysts believe diversity in the Duterte cabinet seems to be a result of a well-thought-out plan.
Siguro, ito ay dahil si Mayor Digong gusto mag-inject ng more representation, no, from Mindanao and peripheries.
Maraming tumulong sa kanila sa eleksyon na ang appointee ng mga grupo na yon, dala nila yung coalition nila eh.
Mga younger ones before did not succeed daw, so he's trying older guys.
But will a team of people from different persuasions cause problems? This UB professor says that remains to be seen.
We're seeing a president who's appointing people from different sectors. I think this is the first time that we're seeing that, no? Yung ganun ka halo-halo.
Recently, Duterte's Social Welfare Secretary Judy Taguibolo disagreed with his plan to bury dictator Ferdinand Marcos at the libingan ng mga bayani. Taguibolo is a victim of martial law.
Is that enough for me to say, oh, I don't want to be part of your cabinet? I don't think so.
Former Executive Secretary Ronaldo Zamora believes it's important for any president to have access to all available information when the time comes to make difficult decisions.
In fact, what you should expose the president to is all of these debates.
We are not only looking after one particular group, but this is for the common good.
The president's men have met as a group twice, still getting to know each other, and still too early to predict how exactly they will blend as a team. But many hope for the best because, after all, despite their differences, one thing they agree on is to work for this man, Rodrigo Duterte. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.